All right. It's Friday night. I'm going to play some Friday Night Magic. There's Friday Night Magic at Home. The Jumpstart decks is the event. And so here I go into it. Hit start. It says choose your deck. And we'll just go straight down the list. So first one's Dinosaur Archaeology. Give it a shot. I haven't looked at these decks yet. I don't know what's going to win, what's going to lose. All the decks should be balanced against each other, but I don't know. Sometimes something slips through. It's a little loud in my ears. I better turn that down. So I will keep this opening hand. So, watch your screen. The Thriving Lands are all a color they tap for, and they also color for when you put in. Oh, hello. Who am I playing against? Lychee Soup? Does lychee make a good soup? I don't know. What's this? 03. Well, it gives me a cheap blocker, I'll play it. And for 5 and tap, sacrifice, does 3 damage to a target. Okay. And there's a 3-1 doggy. And it gets indestructible till end of turn when a non-creature spell is cast. That's pretty powerful. Alright. I'm going to play the Browsing Pteranodon and have it savagely stomp that dog. I'm quitting attacking with the 0-3. Nice! Yeah, that was pretty nice. Thanks. Oh, he pacified the Pteranodon. He's just going to sit there and watch the fight. That's not very cool. Go play Chromatic Sphere. And commune with dinosaurs. We're in Roscuff Frill back for the next turn. No attacks, end the turn. It's a wall that makes something unblockable. 3-3 that can't be blocked if he's played more than 2 cards. Fascinating. Alright. You know what? Pull a green out of that from the blue to draw a card. Drop this guy. Come on. Draws and discards one. Oh, so he's unblockable. I see. Yeah, well, gonna have to take that. I'm gonna love what I play next turn, though. Forest. In with my 4-2 guy. Nothing blocking. Okay, he just takes the 4. Can I do it this way? Drover of the Mighty. Mana acceleration and a 3-3 body. That was kind of pointless. And then Galt up Primal Hunger, a 12-12 trample. For 2 mana. Alright, now it's a game. Every draw card, it gets a +1/+1. Oh, wow. Well. Still think I got him outpowered. Yeah, this guy alone is bad news for his whole board. He's got a little bit of defense, but 12 trample coming. Yeah, good game. You doomed, dude. Bye! Alright. So the dinosaur deck works well. What'd you give me? Ox or bonus? 4-2 ox. When you use the battlefield, discard your hand, draw 3 cards. He escapes for 2 red and exile 8 more, and he comes back as a 5-3. I mean, maybe a good thing. Oh wait, cancel. I forgot to change decks. Alright, next one is called Discarding Angels. I hope I'm not the one discarding the angels. See how it goes. Alright, 3 mana to start. 1/1 lifelink with a buff for a lot of mana. -6/-6, Tiny Bones, Fell Spectre. I'll keep it. Tiny Bones. What? Oh my. Death's Approach. Looks like the creature's a good thing to play first. So we started off with a rogue. It says when you play rogues, mill 2. So I already got 2 cards in my graveyard. And there's another rogue, so there goes 2 more. Oh, this is getting annoying fast. Gonna play the swamp. Attack with this 1/1 lifelink guy. Hopefully he trades. No, no trade? Alright, Tiny Bones. Attack. I'm gonna drop that. Must be white for the other color. Another control of page. Oh, I had that in my hand. I should have played that. Oh, man. He's just moving my library right into my graveyard. Look at that. That's super effective in this format, because we only get 40 cards to start. I'm just taking the 3. Play this. Thank you. Buff him with the page. So I'll gain two and he'll lose that creature. Alright, I could play Sarah Angel. What I really want to do is make him discard two cards. There they go. And now, death's approach on this thief. I could have used the Chupacabra and the Linvala. That would have been great too. Touch and go for a bit. Mana Rock. It's a nice rare land. Okay. Time to try a different deck. Goblin Minions! That sounds like my kind of deck. I like goblins. I like minions. This sounds like a highly aggressive deck. I might be sacrificing a lot of critters. I guess I'll keep it. It looks a little slow. Mountain. Okay, swamp. Oh, Goblin Shortcutter. 2-1. He had to enter the battlefield ability, but he was the first creature down, so that part didn't matter. What's this? Gets +1/+1 until end of turn for 3 mana. When it or another creature dies, target player mills a card. Yeah, right. Full trade. Don't mill a swamp, please. target. Now just play the dutiful attendant. What you got? What you got? Looks like I got three goblins next turn to play. Unless something better comes along. Two on flying, when it dies, it drains two life. Okay. Well, let's play Beetleback Chief. I need to attack right now. The next turn. Next turn, I have some damage. Huh? That's a plus two. Alright, so first play is that. Oh, I could have used that. Oh well. Swing in. Let's do some damage. What? Oh, wow. He mills you for the damage taken. I did not see that before. Then he's gonna tap him down. He needs to keep that as a blocker. Save you. Takes the bait here. Nope. Wise. Mostly. Alright. I need to look at my graveyard. Who do I want back in hand? This is a sacred creature. Discard a card if you do, draw a card. Okay, so gains indestructible. Nah, let me do this. Okay. Resolve. menace is going to help here. Alright, I want it all done to him first, yes, because I don't want to hit Mr. Milne. Can't block flyer. Just gonna go wide around him here. Sacrifice a creature. Goblin token. Swing. I got this. Good game, bro. What's this guy do? When you use the battlefield, reveal the top 6 cards of your library. Play goblin creature cards, converted mana cost 5 or less from among them onto the battlefield and the rest of the bottom in order. Wow. So he makes all the goblins come to the yard. I like that. What's Mr. Funky doing here? He's just running down the clock? Is that what we're going with? This does not make for good streaming. I apologize. This guy is being a sore loser, it looks like. He can't defend against everything swinging around him. And he's definitely not dealing damage on the scale I am. Target him. Sack a goblin. Target him. Sack a goblin. That's victory. Okay. Goblin minions. Alright, nice little going wide strategy. Milling rogues. This is the one I've played against the last 2 times and beat, so I might not have good luck here. I don't know. Maybe it'll work for me, or it didn't work for them. We shall see. Okay, well, it's a hand worth keeping. Opponent's going first. That's an interesting one. Hello. Yak ain't miss. Alright. Not quite sure what that means, but alright. What are they playing? Blue and green. Oh, they got the dinosaur deck. I might get run over here, guys. We shall see. Actually, a 2-3 or 2-4 creature. It's a good card for high toughness blocker. Or just anything 2 toughness that's really annoying you, you can kill it. Taking damage and losing it. Yep, bonus damage. Nice. Attack next round. That can't block. I don't want to lose that. I don't want to trade that with it. So I want to play this. And no attacks. Let him take the 2 damage. Artifact guy that does 3 damage direct. That's gonna be painful. Replace the chromatic sphere. He has to attack with the juggernaut. He attacks with the 0-1 as well. Interesting choice. I will say no blocks. I can take 5. I have plans for next round. Oh, he had a titanic growth. Alright, so I take 9. That's okay. So I'm gonna play Night Shade Stinger. Gloves, gloves. Next there, I'm not gonna lost that trick. Still amazing too. Yeah, I pushed Galta into the graveyard. Happy about that. There's that old wound again. Two death touch when it attacks by controlled creature. Okay. So 2/2 death touch becomes a 4/4 as long as it's got something big to attack alongside it. Or no, if you just control something big. Alright. So now, the plan with the feeder. Pass. Choose blocker. Block. We can make 3/2 lifelink, so it should be a trade, and I'll gain 5 life. Because 3 for hitting him. 2 for his dying that gets drained off his head. Yeah. Alright, alright, alright. So. Play it this turn. Bummer. Oh, that wound has done a lot of damage this game. I'm glad he had something just big enough to survive it. Now, what's his plan? Something to get some land, okay. A little late for land ramping, but I guess it's the card you have in hand. And he draws a card with a sphere. Destroys that wound enchantment, okay. Pretty wise to get rid of that before it kills him. Guy. Everybody hurts sometimes. One, two, take the draw. Well, I don't think I want to sweep away that one. He'll get an artifact back. That'll sweep away. through minus three till end of turn. I know it's my go. I'm thinking about my options. The 2-3 or Mr. Lightning. Now he could spend all his mana to make a dinosaur token. But it won't help much. Draw three, discard two, or an artifact. So he's looking for options. Alright. Cards left in library. I'm at 22. Probably not going to win by milling him at this point. 3-3 defender. Can attack as though it doesn't have defense. It's got a big dinosaur. Alright. And there's another big dinosaur. Attacking with, really? This round. Makes a dinosaur token. Alright. Doesn't have haste. A little hand filter wizard. Alright. Sweep away that guy. Trade there. Well, that's dead either way, right? How many does he have left? 8? Yeah. Go like that. Oh, I'm glad I saw that savage stomp go away. Milled him out. I made it work. It was tight, but I made it work. Oh, that Teferi's tutelage saved me right at the last minute. How long we gone? 40 minutes? Alright. Well, let's try the next one. Plus one doctor. Okay. One guy, 9999. I would end up against that one guy, wouldn't I? I'm gonna take the free mulligan, because I'm seeing a slow start with that. Oh, no. No. That is worse. 3 forests and 4 white cards, no. Okay, now they agree. I will send the Armorcraft Judge to bottom. The Speaker of the Heavens. Gonna swing in against a 1-3 with a 1-1. That's silly. Oh dear. Chandra's Pyroline. I need another mana. In combat on your turn, you control another creature with power for a greater put a pulse and pulse. Okay, so I'll just put the other Lifeleap guy down. Zero attacks. This Boros deck looks like it could get first fast. Well, mine looks more like a slow build right now. I'm gonna say don't block. I'll take two. No, I'll take one, because his thing wasn't triggered. That's one less tricky guy he has. Really need mana. Four drop and a six drop. Where's the low cost stuff? Where's the stuff that triggers the airy? Not to mention the stuff that triggers the speaker. Oh dear. In here when I don't see anything with power four. I mean, okay, this makes 4/4 angel tokens, but you gotta get to 27 life first against a guy that's trying to bring your life total down. Seems a little silly. Ooh, there's the guy that combos with it. Except I can only play him for 3. Well, he's got a Faith's Fetters too, that hardly seems fair. Some help. That's not helping. Is that helping? Well, plus it was better on the battalion. Gotta say no attacks. Maybe I can defend my way to victory here. Just my turn to combat, okay. Okay, so the two biggest ones are getting chunk blocked. Block a 2-2. So I broke even this round. That lady. Me a griffin. Make them think it's a combat trick. And he scoops. Oh, goodness. Lucked my way out of that one. Really. Okay. Plus one doctor is a little slow. Smashing lens. Is it a land destruction? I don't normally play land destruction because I think that's not sporting. Let's see if that's what it is. Flame, hungry flames. Okay. It's not a land destruction deck by the looks of it. It looks like just a high power creature and burn deck so far. Maybe the green's got some grab more lands cards to it. Oh, yep, that's a grab more lands Hydra. Nice. He might shock this guy, I don't know. Or eliminate, that works too. And then he scoops. But I'll take it. I mean, it's a win as far as I'm concerned. Oh, I have four of him already, I think. Oh well. Alright, what's left? Spellcasting Legion. This looked like a really effective deck that the other guy didn't quite know how to utilize. And again, maybe I don't know how to utilize it either. Gonna take the three mulligan because two land. Oh, that's bad too. Still two land, but I got that guy and those guys, so I'll keep. I'll put the Faith Spetters at bottom. Say hello to Beats Electric. He's electric, can I be electric too? Oh boy, he's got the mill deck. Well, no point in attacking into a big wall. Might be able to punch past it with that. There goes more cards. And there goes more cards. Wow, he's already at 8. I got the stab wound on my dude with 3 toughness now. She's officially on the other foot. That's a fire lane. No attacks. What can we do? That non-combat damage. That's supposed to be just more than a non-combat spell. Now he's recycled. Still isn't worth it to attack. There's the kind of spell I wanted to see. Smash. Smash with that, that, that. Had a tricky dude to bait it. Well, well, well. Itchy Rogue. Getting rogues, and I keep getting junk. Yeah. Too much junk! Not enough offense cards. That deck's just poorly made. All I have to say is it's poorly made. Tree-hugging Witcher. Okay. So tree folk and witches. Interesting combination, I guess. Lazarus Rift, huh? Draw tree folk, but that's much later in the game. Interesting. Worth keeping. Hello, Lazarus Rift. I abused that card a lot back when it was first printed. A lot. I have so many ways to bounce it to my hand. There's a kitty. If you kill it, you discard a card. Card. Oh wow, that Larcenist draws a card every time though, wow. Cards. Alright, how do I want to do this? I want to do that and that. Kill the Larcenist. Whoa. Four drop that makes 4/1/1 tokens? That's pretty wild. Here's my witch. What's this? 4/4 reach as long as you draw 2 or more cards this turn, you get +1/+2 and witch plus 2. Blocks the 2/2, blocks the dog. Making tokens of my own! Noxious Mutt. Oh, takes out an enchantment. 3-4 with disenchant ability. How annoying. I paid a whole lot for that one sapperling token. Which I don't normally like, but that's kind of how things shook out. What the heck is that? A 5/5 flying sphinx. If you draw a card while your library has no cards in it, instead put 5 +1/+1 counters on it. Discard 3 cards with different names to draw 5 cards. Oh wow. You know what? Let's both draw. Good, I gotta land. A warden down. So no attacks. Tap target creature. That's messed up, yo. Drop a bat. Drain 2 life. Say no attacks. So watch, he'll tap the sage, because it's got 4/4 in reach. Right. That's okay, my trick works with the bat too, as long as he doesn't draw another card. +1/+1 counter on each other creature you control. Oh boy. No. I scoop. That's too good a play. That messes me up where I can't do my trick. Oh, cancel. Alright, green-black deck is trash. I'm gonna try that white-blue one he just beat me with. Well-read dogs. Certainly seems to be a more aggressive deck than what I got. But not with that starting hand. Alright, that's better. Start with an island. Say hello to Eomer. I guess he's a little wingspan of some kind. Tattoo Vigilant Dog. +3 until end of turn, and he has flash. And I got an opt here too. You know what? Read the book. Choose and discard the opt. We flying vigilant. And he loses a life and draws a card, because I discarded a card. That is sorcery. This is Suspicious bookcase. Well, play that. Pick room. Fly overhead. Pass turn. Burglar rat. Resolve. I will discard the suspicious bookcase. Look at that, a 2/5 hound that says no ruffian. And then I discard a card. Well, the Thriving Isle's gonna go. Alright. Make him a curious alpine watchdog. So now when he attacks in the air, I draw a card. Yeah. I'm gonna draw a card. And I release the hounds! +1/+1 for each creature card in your opponent's graveyard. So, Rambunctious Mutt. That's the disenchanting dog. He just gained the life. But I don't want to make any discard it. Let me see what else I draw when I hit with this guy. Take action, yes. You know what? Pacify the white. That's the correct play. Yeah, and then he gains 5 life with that. Sarah Angela. That's gonna buy him some time. Ah, the Chupacabra! Kills that guy. Destroys that idol. Everybody swings in. Because I gotta try to punch past this now. To win this one, and I'm not going to if I'm drawing land when I need creatures or enchantments to stop the angel. That was embarrassing. Oh well, one deck left, right? Yep, wizards and dragons. Hopefully this is better built than that red-white one. Kept waiting for some good spells to come up. I guess I'll keep. I'm gonna need another island, but the Sage Rose Savant might help with that. that has flash. Really? The islands I need? Really? Oh, this game just has it out for me. I see how it is. Alright, Sage's Roast of Honor. Scrying 2. Can't cast it. Goes two more islands. Oh god. This is turning into a bad joke really fast. It's a 4-3. I'm just gonna take it. And I have to discard a card, because what? Creature control plus one. Oh jeez. Alright, the Wizard's Retort, I can't even cast it if I don't have the blue mana, so might as well. Here we go. Exile that. This guy. I'll chop that guy too, so I won't discard either of these. Alright. Terror of the Peaks. Dealing an Arcanist. Kill the Black Guard. Yeah, buffable. Arcanist has done his job. I can cast him next turn even if he dies. You know what? Other way. Yeah, I can spend the mana though. For that. Really? I really need to land. Oh, look at that. He came right back. My boy! Well, I lost, but I probably could have won that one too if I just punched its face instead of the creature. And that's what I get for playing for over an hour without breaks. So there's all 10 decks. Most of them seemed pretty decent. Some of them, I don't know. I don't know what they were thinking with that white-red build. Did not work well at all. Alright. Gonna sign off.